What is a nuclear reactor made of? In this lecture, you will learn about the main types of nuclear reactor materials and their specific characteristics. The safety and economics of light water reactors rely on the performance of the materials used in the reactor. These materials must resist extreme conditions such as high temperatures and gradients, a corrosive environment, and intense radiation fluxes. The degradation of materials can lead to reduced performance and, in some cases, failure. We will discuss the materials used for the nuclear fuel, the cladding, the moderator, the coolant, the control systems, and the out-of-core structural materials. In this lecture, we will look at the nuclear fuel and the cladding. Nuclear fuel requires a fissile isotope to sustain the fission chain reaction. Uranium-235 is the most widely used fissile isotope. Natural uranium contains about 0.7% uranium-235 and 99.3% uranium-238. Alternative fuels can use the isotopes 239 of plutonium or 233 of uranium, but these do not occur in nature. Metallic uranium was used in the early reactors as nuclear fuel. However, metallic uranium is particularly sensitive to irradiation effects, and nowadays, ceramic uranium dioxide is used instead. To sustain the fission chain reaction, the natural uranium is enriched during the fabrication process to a concentration of about 3 to 4% uranium-235. The fuel is in the form of pellets with dished faces to accommodate the radial anisotropic expansion during irradiation. The density of the pellet is around 95% of the theoretical density. The remaining 5% porosity serves as a sink for the fission gases produced during irradiation. As for the microstructure, the fuel is made of grains with a size of 8 to 10 micrometers. In the fuel rod, the uranium dioxide pellets are stacked on top of each other and are enclosed in a metallic structure called the cladding. The cladding isolates the fuel from the coolant. A small gap of about 80 to 100 micrometers is left between the pellet and the cladding. This gap is needed to facilitate the loading of the pellets and to anticipate the swelling of the pellets during irradiation. The pellets are kept in place in the rod by a metallic spring that is mounted on top of a pellet stack. The free volume around the spring, called the plenum, is used as buffer volume for the fission gases that are released during the irradiation. This avoids that the pressure inside the rod rises to unacceptable levels. Before closing, by welding the end plug on the top, the rod is pressurized with helium gas at 20 to 25 bars to ensure that the fuel cladding gap and the plenum are filled with gas. Helium is chosen as it is inert and has the best thermal conductivity among the inert gases. The dimensions of a fuel rod depend on the reactor designs. In pressurized water reactors, the fuel rods are about 4 to 5 meters long and have a diameter of 9 to 11 millimeters. In the fuel assembly of a pressurized water reactor, 179 to 264 fuel rods are arranged in a 17 by 17 square geometry and are held together by several spacer grids. The assembly also contains several control rods and a top and bottom nozzle for the coolant. In total, there are 150 to 250 of these fuel assemblies in the reactor core. The cladding material must meet several criteria with respect to its nuclear and material properties. Its constituting elements must have low neutron capture cross-sections, it must be compatible with the coolant, have favorable physical properties, especially high thermal conductivity and high melting point, a good mechanical stability, a good radiation stability, and a low permeability for fission gases and helium. In practice, only a limited number of elements fulfill these criteria. Zirconium was historically chosen as an advantageous material. However, this needs to be a special grade of zirconium with a very low content of hafnium. Hafnium is an element with very similar chemical properties, but with very different nuclear properties. It is a strong neutron-capturing material. Pure zirconium metal is too brittle for practical use, however. Zircalloy, an alloy of zirconium and tin, has been developed to overcome this shortcoming. But this alloy did not have a high corrosion resistance towards the cooling water. Other forms of zircalloy have therefore been introduced, in which small additions of iron, chromium and nickel significantly improve the properties. Zircalloy 2 is used in boiling water reactors, while zircalloy 4 is used in pressurized water reactors. With the increasing target burn-up of the fuel, the demands on the corrosion resistance have increased further, and nowadays alloys of zirconium with niobium have been introduced under the commercial names Zirlo, M5 or E110. Choosing the appropriate cladding material is crucial for the safety of a reactor.